On May 21st of 2023, a new explosive eruption occurred at the Mount Etna volcano in Italy. Beginning at 7:06 a.m. local time, this explosive eruption ejected gas-rich molten rock onto the surface, creating a towering lava fountain. This lava fountain likely towered to a height of at least 500 meters or 1,640 feet, all the while releasing a significant plume of sustained ash emissions. These ash emissions quickly rose to a height of 7,000 meters or 23,000 feet, creating a 30-kilometer or 18.6-mile-wide ash plume even visible from orbit. This marks about the radius of where widespread ash fell on the ground, which soon covered nearly 1,000 square kilometers in 1 to 4 millimeters thick of material. Even at a distance of several kilometers from the volcano, ejected pieces of lapilli, which were up to 2.5 inches in diameter, fell onto the ground. Because of all this activity, and the fact that airborne ash is potentially incredibly damaging to aircraft, the regional Catania Airport was temporarily closed to all aircraft. What had just occurred, although spectacular, was not too unusual given the nature of Mount Etna. The 288-minute-long eruption sequence represents a paroxysm, aka a relatively short yet violent burst of activity. The number of paroxysms which Etna produces can widely vary, ranging from none to more than 50 in certain years. These paroxysms generally infrequently interrupt long periods of low-intensity eruptive activity. Etna, during the last century, has been erupting in some form 83% of the time. The paroxysm which occurred happened to end around 11:54 a.m. local time on May 21st of 2023, being the first true paroxysm to occur at Etna in 15 months. In total, I estimate that approximately 3.6 million cubic meters of tephra was ejected, meaning the latest eruption would register in on the volcanic explosivity index as a 2. It is quite likely that about 10 times this amount of lava was ejected, but the truth is we really aren't sure of the nature of the eruption which just occurred. The reason for this is that despite being within 20 miles of hundreds of thousands of people who can see the volcano, during this entire eruption, not only its summit but also its flanks were shrouded in a dense layer of cloud cover and fog, being so heavy that it even obscured any orange glow that would have been generated by any lava flows or lava fountains. Thus, the reconstruction of the latest paroxysm at Mount Etna was merely a hypothesis-based representation of what may have just occurred. Ignoring two singular explosions which occurred on May 6th and May 14th of 2023, Mount Etna had actually not produced an eruption until today's paroxysm for a little more than 3 months. When a paroxysm occurs at Etna, marking heightened volcanic activity, a number of very different things can happen, with four historically represented possibilities. This ranges from Strombolian or Strombolian-like eruptions, which involve low silica lava with a high gas content that create lava fountains which have been historically up to 3,000 meters or 9,842 feet in height, being some of the tallest lava fountains in the world. It also includes Vulcanian eruptions which produce more viscous lava that forms a temporary cap above a magma conduit that then explodes, producing intense ash emissions and on occasion pyroclastic flows. Flank lava flows can also occur during paroxysms, which can originate at a near-summit fissure or a flank cinder cone which forms during such an eruption, although these are highly infrequent occurrences. The fourth type of paroxysm is a Plinian eruption with a sustained eruption column that creates pyroclastic flows which can travel beyond 5 kilometers distant and deposit centimeters to decimeters and sometimes more thick of ash. Luckily, Plinian eruptions are very rare, having only occurred at Etna 3 times in the last 4,000 years, with the last one occurring in 1787. In the upcoming weeks, one of two things could happen. First, more paroxysms might occur, generating additional spectacular lava fountains which might actually be visible if the cloud layer clears. After all, several recent paroxysms of this volcano have generally occurred within 48 hours of one another. Or there might be yet another temporary lull in eruptive activity which could continue for a few weeks to months. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.